I met this girl when I was 10 years old, and what I love most, she had so much soul. She was old school when I was just a shorty, never knew. Throughout my life she would be there for me on a regular. Not a church girl, she was secular. Not about the money, those studs was Mike checking her, but I respected her. She hit me in the heart. A few New York niggas had dinner in the park, but she was there for me, and I was there for her. Pull out a chair for her, turn on the air for her, and just cool out. Cool out and listen to her. Sitting on bone, wishing that I could do eventually. If it was meant to be, then it would be, cause we related physically and mentally, and she was fun then. I'd be geeked when she come around. Slim was fresh, Joe, when she was underground. Original, pure, untapped, but a down sister. Boy, I tell you, I miss her. Yes, yes, y'all, and you don't stop. To the beat, y'all, and you don't stop. Yes, yes, y'all, and you don't stop. A 1-2, y'all, and you don't stop. Yes, yes, y'all, and you don't stop. A consensus, y'all, and you don't stop. Yes, yes, y'all, and you don't stop. You act, yo, we gotta be the sure shot. That's periodically I would see old girl at the club, sit at the house party. She didn't have a body, but she started getting thick quick. Did a couple of videos and became Afrocentric. Out goes the weave, in goes the braised bees medallion. She was on that tip about stopping the violence. About my people, she was teaching me. By not preaching to me, but speaking to me. In a method that was leisurely, so easily I approach. She dug my rap, that's how we got close. But then she broke to the West Coast, and that was cool. Cause around the same time, I went away to school, and I'm a man dub expanded. So why should I stand in her way? She probably get up money in LA, and she did stunt. She got big pub, but what was foul? She said that the pro black was going out of style. She said Afrocentricity was of the past. She got into R&B, hip house, bass, and jazz. Now black music is black music, and it's all good. I wasn't salty, she was with the boys in the hood. Cause I was new for her, she was becoming well-rounded. I thought it was dope how she was on that freestyle shit, just having fun. Not worried about anyone, and you can tell by how her titties hung. Yes, yes, y'all, and you don't stop. To the beat, y'all, and you don't stop. Yes, yes, y'all, and you don't stop. 1-2, y'all, and you don't stop. Yes, yes, y'all, and you don't stop. Until the beat calm, gotta be the sure shot. Yes, yes, y'all, and you don't stop. Check it on, check it. I might have failed to mention that this chick was creative. Once the man got to her, he altered her native. Told her if she got an image and a gimmick, then she can make money. And she did it like a dummy. Now I see her in commercials. She's universal. She used to only swing it with the inner city circle. Now she be in the burbs looking rockin', dressin' hippie. And on some dumb shit when she comes to the city, talking about popping glocks, serving rocks, and hitting switches. Now she's a gangster rolling with gangster bitches. Always smoking blunts and getting drunk, telling me sad stories. Now she only fucks with the funk, stressing how hardcore and real she is. She was really the realest before she got into showbiz. I did her, not just to say I did it, but I'm committed. But so many niggas hit it that she's just not the same, letting all these goofy do her. I see niggas slamming her and taking her to the sewer, but I'ma take her back, hoping that the shit stop. Cause who I'm talking about, y'all, is hip-hop.